before the this Super Bowl trailer speech, why don't I talk to you guys about BC's Legends of Tomorrow, Season 3, Season 1, of RuPaul. And so far, we're seeing the aftermath, the team is seeing the aftermath of the season finales of Rupa. You know, now they're walking around, they're wondering, like, well, how all this happened, now what are we going to do? T-Rex is, like, right in front of them. But, you know, every time is just completely in shambles right now, guys. Like, dinosaurs are here. You know, T-Rex tried to attack them, but it looks like they got swallowed by a portal of some sort. And now it's behind them. You know? I don't know, Rick. Okay, so Rick is pretty much has his own little intelligence agency to get rid of anachronisms, you know, things that are that, objects that are displaced throughout time. Tell them that they turn into a minor required because I don't want to remember anything. So, Rick pretty much just relieved the Legends of Doom team. I'll get back to you guys. This is crazy. Alright, you guys, I'm back. Sorry for the delay. Right now, we see Sarah working at some kind of retail store. You know, she just threw a knife at the damn chopping board. You know, her manager's like, is this the American Ninja Warrior? So, she had to play the merchandise. Okay, so Sarah just slit the throat of her own manager, her boss. I'm sorry, that's her just in her mind. Wow. I don't blame Sarah either. I mean, that guy's a big jerk. Prick. Mind you, that's in Star City, now we're in Silicon Valley, where you see Ray Palmer. Looks like he works for somebody. So pretty much, Palmer, Ray is telling him about his Adam suit, pretty much. But of course, you know, they're not going to pay him any mind. They think he's insignificant. But I'll get back with you guys. These guys are a bunch of pricks. Now, you know, Ray's boss ridicules him. He said, if it's not how it happens, it's not the future. Now we see Nate pretty much just kicking ass in Central City. And Wally steals the day. Say something fat. Nah, that's for you. That's for you. I'll make it up to you. Twice wrongs on me. That's cool. That's so cool. See, actually, you know, I have a girl waiting on me, so Nate and Amina's right there. Oh, Mix and Aruba. Nice. Mind you, this is 6 months later. go refill my margarita or get off my beach. It's a private beach. Okay, now Rick is ran into Julius Caesar alone. Easier to conquer all the known world, but you're on a horse in whatever degrees weather. I'll get back with you guys.
Okay, so they find out Rip gives them grants them the permission to use the Wave Rider, but only to come to find out that it's actually being used as a simulator. Oh, wow, that's funny. Such a waste. Such a waste. Get back with you guys. It's despicable.
Okay, so now the band's back together, except Hermione, because she left Nate to go back to 1942 to fulfill her destiny. And now Jax and, you know, Grace is back together. You know, Lily's pregnant. So now they're ready to get things back in order. I'm excited. I can't wait. I'm glad this series is still on kicking. They get to Julius Caesar to have to end this toga party, right? And so what Ray did was he used his little dating app. You know, he used Gideon to send it the profile to every single last one on the beach to get them out of the way to take down Julius Caesar. And man, I must say, looking at Sarah's behind is nice. So now Sarah squares up with Julius Caesar. Oh, God, oh. Check me up. I thought about it. I think she's got it, though. Oh, wow, that was a nice Muay Thai knee. Sarah just beat the shit out of Julius Caesar. Defend his ass. Jeez. Hoo-hoo-hoo. And we're good. Alright, guys, this is the rest all I got for you guys. I pray pretty much for more of what happened in the episode in the description box below. This is your boy, Trey Speaks. I love you guys. Thanks for watching. I love you guys. God bless. So after, you know, thinking about it, because Rip found out that they took the Wave Rider, I guess Sarah wants to take, you know, Caesar and ship back to Rip so then they can all be forgiven and they won't get in trouble. I, for one, think it's a good idea. I mean, Sarah is using her better side of her judgment. But at the same time, I really think that they should actually go back to the future if they can after you make the minimal repairs. You know, mind you, you know, when Jax and Stein met up, you know, Jax only had 2 more years as his master's, but he enjoyed being an actual engineer, you know, fixing the Wave Rider. And Stein's time, I'm like, you know, you can be happy, you can do anything you want to. But it's time. But Jax wants to be a superhero. I don't blame him. I would like to do it too.